Hey y'all, welcome back. So my plans got changed today. I was supposed to be with my mama today, but she decided she was going to stay home because it's just so hot. It's like triple digit heat index, but I don't have to tell y'all that. Y'all know. So I went to the gym and I was like, So I called James. I was like, you want Buster and I to come have lunch with you today? He's like, sure. Because I didn't cook anything that we had leftovers to send. So, that just meant your girl was going to the thrift store in Pascagoula, the one on Market Street called Aruka House, because anytime I go have lunch with James, I always go there. And then I always stop by on the way home by the American Thrift Store in Goodwill because it's on my way home. So, I was pleasantly surprised at this thrift haul I've got today. So, let's just get started. I will share with you what I got at the Aruka House thrift store. I was sharing the order in which I found it. How about that? Okay. So, at the little thrift store in Pascagoula, they had a bag, like a Ziploc bag, quart size, of vintage napkins. And the whole bag was either $6.99 or they were 98 cents each. But they were 75% off. And I've picked out this one, this cute little vintage napkin, and I picked it out to go in that little drawer in my armoire in the bedroom. I just thought it was so cute and dainty. I love the little needlework on it. In the store, it actually looked like it was a very light sage green, but now I'm looking at it and it's gray, but that's okay. It doesn't matter, but I just thought that was so cute. But one of y'all give me a great idea to find some like little dainty gloves or some jewels, some pearls or something. And I'm definitely looking for, I would love to find some of those like fishnet lacy looking old vintage gloves that the ladies used to wear. I would love to find a pair of those. So who knows, I may, but until then I'm gonna use this little piece. Well, that's where I bought it. That's what I had in mind for. We'll see if it works out. And then these next two items, I'm assuming she charged me 99 cents a piece because they didn't have a price on them. And based on my total, y'all know, what is my deal with spoons? Just wait, there's more, y'all. This thrift haul has more vintage flatware, so got those. And then last but not least from that particular store, I got this beautiful rug. It was $5.88. It's a 32 by 60. I unrolled it. Nothing wrong with it. I love all the colors. And I'm going to take it outside and clean it really well and let it dry. And my plan is to use it in front of my rocking chair, that little area of my hallway. That's my plan. If it doesn't work out there, I may put it in my laundry room. I don't know. Or I may put it in the kitchen. You just never know. But anyway, I picked it up for $5.88. I thought it was really nice. Okay, so then on my way home, I stopped by the American Thrift Store, met a subscriber. Hey, Tammy, it was so nice to meet you. Thank you for stopping me and chit-chatting with me. It was so much fun. But in there, I found, y'all are not going to believe this. I was like, what? And it still has the original tag on it. Let me grab it. Look at this beautiful wreath. It was originally Hearth and Hand, originally $34.99. I paid $9.99 for it. I love this, and I'm so glad I found this because as much as I love the wreath that I put on my front door, which was also thrifted and a very high dollar wreath, it is just too dark for my dark door. And it just disappears into the door. So I'm going to use it elsewhere. And I'm going to put this on my door and this lighter pine with the red berries. And I'm going to intertwine some little fairy lights in it. I think it's just going to be beautiful. So I was very, very happy to find this for $10. I couldn't believe it. Mind blown. I'm telling you. This is why I can't shop retail, y'all. And then I was looking at the flatware, and y'all, they never had this there. But today, it was like, I had to limit myself what I bought. But I bought this pack of spoons and forks, and I'm going to take them out of the bag so I can show y'all. But each bag was $2.99. This is the spoons. I mean, look. Just look at all that vintage goodness. Oh my gosh. They're so pretty. I love it. I love this. For $2.99, I got that. And then the forks. I have an idea how I'm gonna use them. And y'all, I blame Julie and Danielle. Danielle from Homemade Vintage and Julie from Thrifter for getting me like falling in love with flatware. But look at this. Look at this. And it's the same design as the spoons on the, and I can't read what that says. Anyway, love this. So it was an awesome little flatware day. So can't wait to display that. Okay, for the last item I found at the American Thrift Store, I actually seen an item just like this at an antique store last weekend, and I was like, first of all, I didn't know they made it in this color, and second of all, I don't have one, but I resisted, and then this one was in front of me for $2.99. Well, let me show you. Did y'all know they make green ball jars? And back here it says from 1913 to 1915, 100 year of American heritage made in the USA. The ball jars. I was like, is this legit? So I Google lensed it and it's legit. I was shocked for $2.99. So y'all know it's going to my laundry room, but I thought, wouldn't that be really pretty in the fall with some sunflowers in it? Y'all, I'm so ready for fall. I'm so ready for fall. And speaking of fall, I didn't mean to do that, but we're gonna segue into fall. So I went to the Goodwill and I found two little kitchen towels. And I love this saying for fall. The first time I heard it, I fell in love with it and I just love it. And it says, fall for Jesus, he never leaves. And I got two just like this and it has it on both sides. They're excellent conditions, no stains or anything, 99 cents a piece. And I don't know about y'all, but we go through dish towels here at the house. So I'm gonna get these washed and put up for my fall decor. I'll just hang them on my stove. They can be used if they want to for 99 cents. Y'all, I've said it before, I say it again. We're not ruining a happy home over a dish towel. Ain't happening. So, now I'm gonna go spray my rug down. I use the power wash Dawn, spray the rug down. I go outside and put my water hose on jet and just wash it really good. Let it dry in the sun. And then vacuum over it and it's good to go. So I'm fixing to go do that to this rug so it can be dry and in this hot, hot blazing sun. And then I'm going to figure out where I'm gonna put all my new flatware. I have an idea, so we'll just have to see. So I'll show y'all all that once I get it all done. All right, y'all, there is where I have put my new jar and I am so glad I got that jar. And let me tell you why. First of all, I was feeling kind of guilty because, I mean, let's face it, do I really need another jar? No, I do not. But I do not have one this color. And you see this? Wide mouth? Y'all, hold on, let me open and show you. This makes being able to get the items out of this jar so much easier. Because of its wide mouth, when I would try to use something out of here, it was just so hard to get my hand in that other jar. But this is perfect. So it was not a frivolous, unnecessary purchase. I needed it. No, I really did. And this is where any stray buttons or whatever, they have needle and thread and straight pins. And you'll be surprised, you'll find a random button here or there, and I just stick it in here. And if I find out where it came from, I'll know what to do with it. So, this has worked out perfectly, just like that. Oh, yes. And I mean, up there, you can't tell that it's green, but I know it, and you know it, and That's really all that matters, right?
Here I did a little rearranging so I could put my new spoons and forks. They had knives, like butter knives, and they had larger spoons. I may go back, if they still have them, get those to add to this. But this was originally up there, and that was down here. So I swapped places. I put this little, there's a dolly down in there, which is adding height. And I just stuck this. I might do away with this if I get more spoons and stuff. But I really like it in this. And then come, you know, the change when I decorate differently for fall, this will go away. I've got a different picture I'm going to put here. Oh, I missed it. Oh, low. Can't be messing up my dolly. This is new. I found this at the thrift store the other day. And I have another one of these plates I found at the thrift store. So I have one of these and two of these now. This little coffee cup actually goes with that little saucer up there. So I'm slowly building my blue and white and red and white collection. But I put my other little blue plate, I put it down here. Let me show you. I put it right there. Just another piece to layer. I think I'm gonna get a little, I'm gonna see if I have a little small plate stand to put it on to kind of elevate it a little bit. But if you'll notice in all of my vignettes, there's layers of it because I like to go and look at a vignette and, oh, I didn't see that. Oh, look, and it just is little bits of pieces. You know, there's just something to catch my attention. And so, but I am thinking about y'all swapping this to over here because now I have this, and that's kind of driving me crazy. So I'm probably gonna swap that to there, you know, just swap sides. And if y'all notice, my chicken that I have there on this crock is now over here because the chicken I had here is the chicken I'm using to make the lamp. So that's where I've put this one, but I think I'm gonna get some old rolling pins or some of the rolling pins that I'm gonna like do away with and just kind of put them in there just to kind of like fill it up. And also I want something there that's gonna kind of hide the outlet. So that's just what I'm thinking, but you know, it could change. That's the fun of decorating. You can just do whatever you want, right? I mean, we got first world problems over here, decor. But I just went outside and I've moved my rug over onto our little garden shed. I've laid it flat out. The sun is beaming down, so that'll help dry it. The sun had kind of shifted from over here. It's shaded now and I needed sun to be on it. Not quite sure where that's gonna land. That actually may land in my laundry room because I kind of laid it down on the floor by my rocking chair and it just didn't have the look I wanted, but I may put it in my laundry room and I think that would be pretty in there because it's got all these different colors that I kind of incorporate in the laundry room, so that might be where it goes. Regardless, I'll find a spot for it because I love it. Y'all, I just love rugs. I've always loved rugs. They're just my favorite. I just love decor. I mean, just be real. I just love decor. I just love playing house, y'all. You know, I used to do this when I was little. I can remember being at my granny's. She was such a saint. And I can remember taking everything off the walls and redoing it all. I would tell her I was redecorating. And she let me. And they have never discouraged me, and I have always, always, always loved to decorate. Fun fact, I used to love, well, I still love watching the Flintstones. To me, it's just one of the awesome cartoons. But I would love watching the Flintstones because I would love to see how Wilma decorated her house.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yes. So this decor thing is nothing new for me. I have always loved it. But what has really like kind of like fed the beast, I guess you could say, is when I fell in love with thrifting and I realized what I could get for my money. And my house would be uniquely my house. I do not mind, please do not misunderstand that. I do not mind anybody emulating, copying, having the same things I have, not at all. And I don't even mind people decorating like my house, you know, or getting ideas and, you know, doing it in their home, not at all. My problem is when you're scrolling through Instagram and you're looking at all these people's houses and it's the exact same thing. I will never forget a few years ago, I was scrolling through Instagram and I thought I had was spotted a YouTube creator that I used to watch her channel. I thought it was her house. And when I looked down, I realized it was not her house at all, but it was identical to her house. And that's when it clicked with me. Okay, no, no. And our home should represent who we are and what we like, not what the trends and the fads are. It should be a representation of you and what you love. When people walk into your house, to your home, they should be able to say, yeah, this is totally you, you know? And that's what I want. So that's just my little take on it, I guess you could say. I don't know. Do with that information what you will. But never, ever, ever do I get offended if somebody wants to know what color, like the paint colors or anything like that, or where I got something or if I can link something. The problem is I can't link like 90% of my stuff because it is thrifted. But anything that I can link, I definitely will link for y'all. And if I got it on Amazon, it's already linked down below in my Amazon store. And I understand some of y'all may not want to click on that. And that is totally fine because it is an affiliate link. And if you do click on that, then I do get a tiny commission. I mean, it ain't nothing to write home about. But at the same time, I don't want you to think that I'm being shady and not telling you. Any YouTuber that says they have an Amazon storefront and they will link it down below, they are getting paid if you click on that link and buy from that. Just putting it out there. Some of them are shady and don't disclose that. And it's illegal not to disclose that. But it is, my Amazon store is always down below. If you do click on it and buy something from there, I do receive a commission. But you never have to feel obligated to do that. I will be more than happy to tell you if it came from Amazon and what it was. And a lot of times how I find stuff on Amazon, I'll just search for stuff from what I'm looking for. And then, you know, it pulls up this whole catalog of stuff. But, yeah. So, just want to put that out there for you. All right. Well, I'm going to sit down and start editing some more. Thank y'all for the love and support on my mostly thrifted home. My master bedroom tour. I love my bedroom now. I used to hate it. I love it now. Oh, and it's changed since I filmed that video. I bought an olive tree. Yep, bought an olive tree from Hobby Lobby. Went in there. I'll share it in an upcoming video. But they had it on super clearance. I've been eyeing these olive trees, but I refused to pay $119. I even refused to pay 50% off. But I got it for 66% off. And I walked around the store, and the only difference between the olive tree I got and the one there that's still $119 was the one I got had the spring tag on it. That's it. That's what made it 66% off. The other olive trees that have just the regular Hobby Lobby tags, they weren't 60% off. So, go figure. But I'll show you what it looks like. And this is where I have put it. And I love it over there. I've been wanting an olive tree for that corner anyway. So I just kind of moved that out. And y'all, let me just tell you. Y'all know the little stool that I had the copper pot on? I come up with a genius hack for it. And I'm so glad I have it. I knew there was a reason I held on to it. Let me show you. I put it over here because it is the perfect base for when I pull it out. I set it here. I set my fan up on it, and it blows directly on me right there. Oh, it is heaven on earth. So, yay for that little stool.
I love it. The only reason my fan isn't in here now is because I had it in my utility room while I was drying some clothes.
You're probably saying, what? You had it in your utility room while you're drying clothes? Yes, and I'll tell you why. It gets so hot in that utility room, especially as hot as it is outside. So I have learned that if I'm gonna dry clothes in the day, if I will put my fan in there and let it like circulate, it does not get as hot in there. It does not heat the house up. And I'm able to not be confined to when I can dry clothes, because normally I don't like to dry clothes unless it's early in the morning or late at night because of the heat, but that works for me. So just a little tip there that I've learned. So, all right, y'all, I've yakked on long enough. Let me get to editing this video and see how long it is. So I'll talk to y'all in a little bit.
Real quick, there's my fan. My mom told me, she's like, you never did show me where you put that little picture you thrifted the other day. This is where I put it. I hung it in here on this little peg rack, and I just think it's just adorable in here. I absolutely love it. Now, will it always stay in here? I don't know, but it's here for now. I think it's adorable, and yeah, so my little 99-cent picture right there. Y'all, look at this thing. He is tuckered out. Buster, are you snoozing? Was you snoozing? If there is such a thing as reincarnation, I want to come back as Buster. I want Buster's life. I want Buster's life. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Oh, the sweet baby. Okay, go ahead and lay there and take a nap. Cuteness overload. Okay, y'all. I did swap the surround. I like that better. And I think I am going to do that with the rolling pins on that. And then I'm going there to show you in the bedroom where I put that little handkerchief. Let me open this up. I've done that like that. I did put a piece of scrap wood in here to elevate it, and then I just stuck that little frame, James and I. And that's what that looks like.
All right, y'all, that is going to do it for me today. Thank you so much for hanging out with me for the past couple days. I love y'all, and I will see you in the next one. Bye, y'all.